Bible says that the thief cometh but to steal, to kill and to destroy. But I speak out of the mouth of God that Jesus has come to give someone life and life more abundantly. You are not going down like this. You may have been in the last inning. They may have 2 strikes on you, but you still have a bat in your hand. Somebody says, going out of the place.
When you touch the mantle of Jesus, tell your neighbor to your right, say, neighbor, listen to the message. When you touch the mantle of Jesus, something always happens. My brothers and sisters, and you that are watching me live, I want you to know that throughout the Bible, we read many times about mantles. Somebody say mantles. The mantle was first mentioned in the Old Testament. We find the word mantle in the Bible in the Old Testament. And it was usually connected as a garment to prophets. Garment, somebody say prophets. Which included like prophets like Elijah. Elisha. So we see that it was worn by several prophets, and it was significant. Somebody say significant. It has many biblical meanings. I want you to understand, because the message here, when you touch the mantle of Jesus, what happens? And I'm going to help you understand what the mantle of Jesus is, what it does, but better yet, how you can touch that mantle today. Hallelujah. The mantle has many and several biblical meaning. It has meaning both physically and spiritually. Somebody say spiritually. This mantle that they wore in the Old Testament and the mantle that Jesus wore are mantle that if we understand what is their connection in the spirit, we can touch them. Somebody say touch them. So in the old, we see it very clearly. But ladies and gentlemen, whether you read it in the old or not, the mantle of Jesus have not changed. I said the mantle of Jesus has not changed. It still carries power. Somebody say power. Let me tell you what a mantle is. A mantle, as I said, it has a physical and a spiritual recognition. In the physical sense, a mantle is a cloth that people used, especially in the Middle East, to cover themselves from the elements, to cover themselves from the weather. It used to keep them warm. It used to cover them from the sun, the harshness of the heat or the sun. It has a physical, practical a meaning. But ladies and gentlemen, it also has, and most importantly, it has a spiritual meaning for the purpose of why we want to share this message with you. Now let me put something here. The Bible says that as many as touched him, in other words, his hem of his garment, that rendition does not give us the full understanding of what happened. They were not just touching, and they were not just touching a piece of cloth. The word touch comes from the word that literally means to cling to. It means to attach yourself and not let go. So it wasn't just, no. See, the touch needed to be a touch that identified the heart of the toucher. See, their touch was a touch of desperation. Their touch was a touch of faith. touch was a touch that said enough is enough. So when you have that attitude in your heart, you just don't casually touch it. You grab on and say, I'm not letting go until I get my blessing. I'm not letting go until I see my manifestation. I'm not letting go until I see my breakthrough. I'm not letting go.
Hallelujah.
Can I teach you the Bible to this morning? It wasn't a touch like Americans think when they read it. A touch. No. But it was a touch that I had a significance. A touch that I had determination behind it. A touch that I had the attitude that said, I'm not going to disconnect until I connect well. A touch that said, I'm not leaving until I get what I came for. I don't know if I'm speaking to somebody here that came with a desire and has the desire to say, I'm not leaving until the prophet locates me, until Jesus looks at my case, until my case changes. I don't know. There are people with that type of attitude here. If they're not people like that, I am wasting my time. But I believe that there's someone here that is about to do this. Sit down. Sit down. Watch this. See, King James problem. See, the American language is too superficial. It's too superficial. So you don't get the gist of the spirit of the speaker. Because he was writing in Aramaic. He was writing in Greek. And those languages are more deeper in meaning than the American English. He says, they touched the hem of his garment. Somebody say Holy Ghost fire. Right? Now, the word here, garment, is translated mantle. It is not a... You see, Jesus was a rabbi. There were three people that used to wear mantles in the old days. One, as we know, the prophets. Another person that wore a mantle was the priest. And the other one was the king. Jesus was all three. So they not just touched the garment of a priest, the garment of a prophet, the garment of a king. No, they touched the corresponding clothes, call a mantle, because a mantle in the original Hebrew, like in the Old Testament, mantle has three different definitions. One of the definition is glory. So when they touch his garment, they touched his mantle. When they touched his mantle, they were touching his...
Hallelujah.
Can I continue? Are you learning something? Tell your neighbor. Are you learning something? Are you learning something? It also means, watch this, the word in the Hebrew is, somebody say, adare. Adare. Adaret, it means glory, but it also means, it means two other words. One is splendor. So when they touched him, they were touching his glory. And let me tell you something, God is not independent of his glory. Wherever his glory is, his spirit is. Wherever his glory is, his power is. Wherever his glory is, situations must change. Wherever his glory, oh my.
Hallelujah.
See, the Hebrew people, the children, they understood Hebrew culture. That's why when they landed back on the shores of the Sea of Galilee, Gennesaret, the people saw him. And the Bible says they recognized him. They knew him. You know what the word recognize mean there? He's not your, Jesus. No. To recognize in the Hebrew, to know somebody, their language understood this, that when you really know somebody, to know them is to have knowledge, understanding of who they are, what they are, what they can do, what you have seen and heard them do, and you have other witnesses testifying of the character and name of that person. So when they landed on the Sea of Gennesaret, and the Bible said they knew him or they recognized him, what they were saying, that they knew that this was not an ordinary man. This was not an ordinary prophet. This was not just a rabbi. This was somebody that came with glory, came with splendor.
Oh! Hallelujah.
The Hebrew language, the people understood this. No wonder they ran all over to get sick people. Huh? And that's the problem with the church today. We don't know that the Jesus that carries the mantle, his name is glory. His name is splendor.
Yes.
His name is magnificence.
Yes.
Which is the other Hebrew meaning for the mantle. I mean for the knowing. Watch this. Watch this, ladies and gentlemen. When they understood that he was carrying something, they understood that their problem was over. They understood that this was the end of my train of trouble, my train of disappointment, my train of setback,
yes,
my train of being left back.
Yes.
My...
Hallelujah.
So they ran and they got everybody. Hey, come, the glory is here. The splendor is here. Now watch this. Watch this. The Bible says that they touched his garment, right? They touched. As I said, it wasn't an ordinary touch. Somebody say it wasn't an ordinary touch. All right. Now, this mantle, this garment that means glory. That means splendor. That means magnificence. Somebody say magnificence. It had some meaning why they wore it. Number one, the mantle represented you're carrying God's authority. See, the Hebrew understood this, because there was only three types of people that carried a mantle, that put on a mantle: the prophet, the priest, and the... They understood the meaning of my mantle. The church, especially in America, does not understand. But you're going to understand today. I say you're going to understand today.
Amen.
Jesus is here with his mantle. And all of you here will have an opportunity to cling, to hold on, to grab, and say, I am not leaving Jesus until you change.
Yes. Hallelujah.
It signifies, it represents you're carrying, you're wrapping yourself with God's authority. When a prophet had a mantle on, it was an identification from heaven. You're my man. You're my spokesperson. My endorsement is upon you. That's why the Bible says, touch not.
Yes.
Because when you touch the anointing, you are touching the mantle that is upon that minister. And the mantle represents his glory, God's glory.
Yes.
Represents God's splendor. Represents God's magnificence. So when you touch the anointed, you are touching the splendor. You are touching the glory. And whoever touches the glory, somebody say fire.
Fire!
prophet. Listen, it was, you know how they recognized prophets in the old days? Huh? Even if they didn't know their name, they looked at their vestures. They looked at what they were wearing. And they knew, that's why anytime Elijah used to go into town, the king Ahab, you say, hey, are you here for problems or? Somebody say problems.
Problems.
Listen, it has to do a mantle. In the spiritual parlance, it represents a governmental position in the spiritual realm. In other words, you are part of the government of heaven. Oh, this is dangerous, folks, but yet powerful. When you have a mantle upon you, and this was the mantle of Jesus, he was the government is behind you. The government of heaven is endorsing you, and the military of that government, wherever you go and that mantle is on you, the military Hallelujah. Will go behind you. Yes. He will protect you. Yes. He will fight for you. Yes. I pray for somebody. Hallelujah. Your mantle is about to show up, and the military is up.
Thank you, Jesus.
Sit down. Sit down. Sit down. Sit down. Listen, the mantle of Jesus. Can I talk to you about this mantle? Let me read it. Put that scripture up. That scripture in Mark chapter 6, verse 56. Put it up again. Can I take this off? You notice I only give this to my. There's a secret. Okay. All right. Listen. The Bible says, let me read it. And whithersoever he entered into villages, how many of you feel Jesus in this place? Whether he entered in cities or country, they lay the sick in their streets, and they besought him that they might touch, if it were, the border. See, that's the wrong rendition. King James, he tried. Huh? He tried. But it's okay. The border of his garment. They understood, as I mentioned already, the children of Israel, the Hebrews, the Jewish people, they understood the significance of a mantle, the meaning of a mantle. And I just explained to you the concordance definition of a mantle. Somebody say glory. Somebody say splendor. Somebody say magnificence. This was what this mantle of Jesus represented. They understood this, and they understood that priests or rabbis or prophets, they carried such mantles. So when they saw Jesus, when they understood who he was, you see, that's the key. It's not just seeing Jesus. Many people saw Jesus, but only a few people knew Jesus. Many people saw Jesus, but only a few recognized that the glory of heaven was upon him. They recognized him as a prophet. They recognized him as a priest. And later they recognized him as the soon coming king. I preach under the anointing of the gospel of the Holy Spirit that this Jesus is still a prophet. Yes. This Jesus is the priest of priests. Yes. This Jesus is the king of kings. Yes. The world must hear. America, I am praying for you. There will be a visitation of the mantle of Jesus, the mantle of glory, the mantle of splendor, the mantle of magnificence that is about to embark America from the East Coast to the West Coast, from the North down to the South, and America will come to the revival of the Holy Spirit. America, get ready. I am preaching by the power of the Spirit.
Hallelujah.
It's going to happen. I said it's going to happen. This mantle has not changed. Let me tell you something. If you work for Walmart, we're coming. You work for Costco? Huh? You better sell your stuff now. Because when that time comes, in the middle of the cashier's line, we're going to begin to cast out devils.
Yes.
We're going to begin to heal the sick. We're going to begin to prophesy the mind of the Lord.
Hallelujah.
We're going to begin to do signs and wonders in the name of Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Costco, get ready.
Hallelujah.
Costco, Mark, get ready. Walmart,
yes,
get ready.
Yes.
Macy's, get ready.
Yes.
Jesus' mantle is about to visit you.
Hallelujah.
See, the mantle of Jesus, it carries the DNA of the Father. The mantle of Jesus is the anointing of the Holy Ghost. Can I speak to the church that understand? The anointing of the Spirit, the mantle of Jesus, as I said, is the anointing of the Spirit upon him. You say, prophet, how do you know that? Look at what he says. Put that scripture for us in Luke chapter 4, verse 18. Watch this. Hey. Luke chapter 4, 18. Luke chapter 4. Uh-huh. This is the mantle. This is the anointing. The mantle of Jesus is not an ordinary cloth.
Yes.
I said no. The mantle of Jesus is the anointing of the Spirit. And that's why he said the Spirit of the Lord. The Spirit. Give me somebody. Give me that thing for my wife. Doesn't matter. Put it on me, Deacon. Come out. Put the mantle of the Spirit. He said the mantle.
Yes.
The Spirit of the Lord is upon me. And he has anointed me. He has empowered me. He has given me the mantle.
Hallelujah.
He has given me something to work with. Oh my God. The mantle of Jesus is the anointing of the Spirit.
Yes.
Somebody give three people a high five and tell them the mantle is the anointing.
The mantle is anointing.
Sit down. Sit down. You're getting too excited now. This is supposed to be Labor Day weekend. You're supposed to being in a beach or picnic, but there's no better picnic than the word of God.
Yes.
Than the anointing.
Yes.
Can I speak to somebody?
Speak, Papa.
There is no greater.
Hallelujah.
Papa. I need to finish. 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 The mantle of Jesus is the mantle. I was in my room yesterday, and the last few days, shutting in my room, and the Lord, even my wife, she said, I was about to go knock on your room to see if you were alive. Now that I see you, I know you're alive. Okay, so, listen. The mantle of Jesus is the mantle of power. I was on my knees in prayer. I was shut in for a few days in fasting and prayer, and the Lord said to me, my mantle is a mantle of somebody say, of power. Somebody say, of power from on high. And that mantle, he said, I have given to my people through the Holy Ghost. It is a power from on high. You say, where is that in the Bible? Thank you. I like a Bible reading people. Look at Luke chapter 24, verse 49. Look at what it says about that mantle from on high. Kaya bosataya. And behold, I send the promise of my Father upon you. Look at your neighbor. He's talking to you. Tell him this word is concerning you. The promise of my Father upon you. But tarry ye in the city of Jerusalem until I give you a new garment, until I put a new mantle up. Until I come to change your garment. I'm about to remove your garment of weakness,
Hallelujah.
Your garment of failure, your garment of
Hallelujah.
Going down, your garment of disappointment, for
yes.
a mantle, for a garment of power
yes.
from on high. I don't
yes.
know, there's a people in America and in this church that understand God is a God that changes mantle today.
Hallelujah.
Whatever mantle you don't want to have, today it will be changed to the mantle of power from on high.
Hallelujah.
Sit. 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 Somebody say mantle of power. The mantle of Jesus, it represents the authority of his name. See, when they touch the mantle, when they touch the mantle, they were touching the authority above all authority. Jesus said, all authority. Ay, 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 ay. Give me the mantle. Give me the mantle, Deacon.
Hallelujah.
Put the authority on me. Put it on me. Put it on me. Wait. Take it off. Take it off again. Take it off again. He's in the grave. He's in the grave. He's beat down. He's scarred. The grave and demons had him. They were having a good time. They said, we finally got him. But all of a sudden, the Holy Ghost came into that grave.
Hallelujah.
He started shaking. He started shaking the stone. And Jesus got out from the grave, and he came out of the grave. When he came
yes.
out in the resurrection, the Father said,
yes.
I give you now a mantle of all authority, all power in heaven and earth and under the earth. The mantle of Jesus has power in all three kingdoms.
Yes.
That's why when you say in the name of Jesus,
yes.
it is the mantle that has authority.
Hallelujah. Yes. Yes, it is.
Sit. Sit. Listen. Listen. The mantle of Jesus is the mantle. They were touching the mantle of the prophet of prophets. Can I talk to you? In the Old Testament, they had prophets. I know that. And they all had mantles, right? Moses had a mantle. Elijah had a mantle. Even Elisha had a mantle. Even Samuel had a mantle. And let me tell you something. And they did wonderful work through their mantle. Moses, through his mantle, he was able to bring out from the hand of Pharaoh over 3 million people by his mantle. But the mantle of this man called Jesus, this is a greater mantle. Moses was able to rescue 3 million, but the mantle of Jesus is able to rescue humanity. He said, come unto me, all ye that labor and are heavy laden, and I will give you rest. Somebody praise the name. Even Samuel had a mantle. Wasn't he a prophet? I said Samuel had a mantle. Samuel had a mantle. And with his mantle, he was able to judge Israel 40 years. But this Jesus, his mantle is not a 40-year mantle. He said, a forever, all eternity, all forever,
yes.
forever. This one is an everlasting mantle.
Yes,
the mantle of
Hallelujah.
Elisha had a mantle that he caught from his father, Elijah. Do you know that Elisha is like an anti-type of Jesus? Okay, that's another preaching. That's another preaching. Elisha caught the little mantle of his father, Elijah. Elijah did wonderful works with that mantle. Elijah, he fought the demons of Baal and the demons of Jezebel. 750. 850 total. 850 demons with that mantle that he had, Elijah. With that mantle, he fought 850 demons, but not this Jesus. His mantle was not an 850 demon fighting mantle. This mantle has all power to trample against scorpions and serpents and all the powers of the devil. Let me tell you something, the mantle of Jesus is a mantle that terrifies and terrorizes hell. Yes, somebody say, mantle of Jesus.
Mantle of Jesus.
Elijah with his mantle. In the book of 2 Kings chapter 4. Read it for yourself when you have time. The king of Syria is planning, concocting. We're going to kill them. The spirit of Elijah went from Samaria and stood in the midst. The king here, everybody here, they couldn't see him, but he could see everything. So the king is saying, hey, we're going to enter here. We're going to come this way. We're going to camp here. We're going to get them here. Elijah said, okay. So he left by the spirit of God. Some of you call it astral projection, but it's okay. It's okay. So he left. Hey, he said to the king of Samaria, he said, Hey king, your enemy, the king of Syria, is concocting to fight you. He will be camping here. Go send scouts to look at what's happening. And every time the king of Syria will try to execute, failure. Because there was a prophet in town. I said there was a prophet. The devil cannot hide. Amen. The prophet represents Jesus. He represents the word of God. He represents the representative of heaven. He represents the yoke destroying anointing. Wherever the devil is planning, whatever the devil is planning against you, by the eye of the Spirit, by the anointing of the Spirit, we will uncover the plans of the devil. Somebody say fire.
Fire.
See, what's this? Elijah catches them. He caught them. Round them up. And with 20 loaves of barley, he feeds an whole Syrian army. 20 loaves because of his mantle. But the mantle of Jesus, the Bible says it was not a 20 loaf miracle mantle. It did not just feed 100 people or 200 like the army. The mantle of Jesus took two loaves, two fish and five loaves, and fed five. This mantle can do exceedingly abundantly above all that you can ask or think. Don't worry, my sister. Don't worry, my brother. That mantle has unlimited power. That mantle is able to feed you, to feed your children, to feed your great.
Hallelujah.
Sit down. By the mantle of Elisha, he raised up a little child, the son of a Shunammite woman. You remember the story? By that mantle he raised one. But the mantle of Jesus, not only did he raise children, he also raised adults. And lastly, he rose himself. The mantle of Elisha could not raise up Elisha, but the mantle of Jesus raise Jesus from the dead. This is a resurrection mantle. I speak over somebody. The resurrection power of the Holy Ghost will come to resurrect your dead thing. Somebody shout and give him praise in the house of God.
Thank you.
Sit down. What happens when you touch this mantle? And they touch the hem of his garment. Demons. As they were writing the Bible, the demons. No. They did not understand Hebrew culture. And the mantle, as I said, was carried by three types of people. Who? Priest. Huh? Prophet and? Was he all three?
Yes.
Huh? What happens when you touch the mantle of Jesus? What happens? Well, the Bible says they all touched the hem of his garment, the mantle. And as many as touched him, what happened? The thing remained the same? Huh? Has Jesus changed his mantle? Huh? Huh? What happens when you touch his mantle? Understand that when you touch the mantle of Jesus, you're touching God Almighty himself. When you touch the mantle of Jesus, healing begins to flow. The Bible says that as many as touched him were made whole. Look. The woman with the issue of blood, did she touch? What happened to her sickness? So when you touch the mantle of Jesus Christ, you that are here, overflowing, everybody, listen to me. This mantle have not changed. I said, America, you that are watching me, I'm coming. You're going to have to extradite me out of this country, remove my citizenship. But as long as my feet are in America, you will hear about Jesus. You will hear about my Father.
Hallelujah.
I said, I'm going to preach Jesus. I know the Congress, you're trying to mess around with the gospel. It's okay. The gospel will outlast you.
Yes, in the name of Jesus.
When you touch his mantle, not only healing flows, but salvation comes. Listen, healing, somebody say healing. Salvation. Protection then is granted. When you touch his mantle, resurrection takes place. I say resurrection takes place. Look at what it says. Again, as many as touched him were made whole. The word whole is, somebody say, sozo. It means to be saved. It means to be delivered from the power that is grabbing you. They were made. You see, read it right. When they touched them, I mean, deep things happened. They were saved. They were delivered from the power of the enemy. Protection came to them. He healed their sickness and diseases, and restoration came to their health. Somebody say, praise the Lord. To be made whole is to be preserved and to be kept from harm in the future. See, this is all by a touch. So you call it a touch. Huh? It was more than just whole. See, the English language is a mess. To be made whole, they were made whole. They is to be, make someone do well again that was not doing well before. You're about to do well again.
I said
things were not working before. I prophesy under the prophetic anointing. Hallelujah. You're about to do well again. Beginning today, I change it. Let everybody begin to do well in this church.
Receive it in the name of Jesus.
To be made whole. As many as touched him, the garment, the mantle of glory, the mantle of power, is to be rescued. from destruction and from imminent danger. So please, my children, let us be students of the word. Don't think I need to finish this chapter because then I'll be satisfied. No! You finish 20 chapters, still don't know anything. By the time you walk out of the house, you forget the book, the chapter, and the verses. So, this will change in Jesus' name. To be made whole is to bring back. The word sozo also includes to bring back from death. Oh my God. Honey, get that shawl for me. The shawl, the prayer shawl. She's so excited, she forgot. Somebody said, we bless you. Look at what it says. The mantle of Jesus. When they touched the mantle, some of them were about to die. They were sick unto death, I guarantee you. But that mantle, when you touch that mantle, is able to bring back people from life. He has resurrection power. I said he has resurrection power.
Amen.
But bring me that. No. Put it on me, mama. Watch this. Put up there Mark 6, 38 through 42. Put it over me. I'm going to show you something. And then with this I'll finish. Le Kaboa. Thank you. Watch this. Please pay attention. Listen, a rabbi, as Jesus was, they wore some things. As I mentioned, one of the elements or one of the clothing items they wore was a mantle. See, it wasn't like this. This is Western. This is Western shape. The mantle of a rabbi, though he had tassels, it was a vesture. Without seams or seamless. And to put it, you had to put it over your head because you only had one opening for you to go to put your head through. And it was without seams. It was very expensive. That's why the Roman soldiers said, let's not break it. There's some money here. Let's cast lots. The mantle of a rabbi, the mantle of a prophet was a seamless mantle. It was not something like this. This is... They just made this thing for you people to believe that you got something. But you know God honors it. Lord, we thank you. He still honors it. Watch this. Look at what he says in Mark chapter 6, beginning with verse 38. He said unto them, how many loaves have you? Go and see. And when they knew, they say 5 and 2 fishes. Continue. And he commanded them to make all to sit down, right? To sit down. Now watch this. Continue. They ate, right? Companies of 50, so forth. Continue. He took the 5 loaves, he took the fish. He blessed it, broke it, blessed it, gave it to them. Continue. They all ate. They were filled. Remember, he's wearing what? Keep in mind this. Continue. And they took up the baskets full of dragons and of the fishes. Continue. They did eat with the loaves. Were about how many? We mentioned that before. Now watch this. And straightway he constrained his disciples to go into the ship and go to the other side. We know the story. They started navigating. They started going into trouble. Jesus started walking on water. All this time, Jesus is wearing what? You're following me here. Now one day, the same one that was wearing this mantle that multiplied the loaves and the fish and walked on water and so forth. One day they called him. And they said, listen, there's somebody that had died. He comes to the house. And the people are crying. The people are crying. And he said to them, look, why are you crying? Why are you making this tumult, this noise, this thing? She's not dead. She's sleeping. Remember what he's wearing. The mantle of glory, power, authority, anointing. Approval from on high. See, when you know what you are wearing, when you know who has endorsed you, you speak with boldness.
Amen.
They started to mock him. The Bible says they mocked him to scorn. Huh? He said, okay, unbelief, get out. Huh? Get rid of unbelief. Unbelief will mess you up. It will block your destiny and blessings. Huh? He said, get out. And the Bible says he only kept his disciple and the mother and father of the child to come in the room. He comes. Remember, he's wearing his what? One day I'll teach on the rabbinical meaning of the tassel, the fringes, the blue ribbon, the blue string, what they represent and why it needs to have 8 strings to be kosher. Okay, that's another preaching. Watch this. Watch this. He comes over the dead damsel, the young girl. Dead. Somebody said dead. He's wearing his what? He says to her, Talitha kumi. Wait a minute. Don't get ahead of me now. He said, Talitha kumi. Say it again. Which is being interpreted, damsel. I say unto thee, what? Arise. Watch this. The word Talitha. Huh? And kumi. Talitha comes from the original root Greek, which means to cover a lamb with the mantle of a shepherd when the lamb is in trouble.
Amen.
You don't understand here. He's wearing his mantle. He comes to a lamb. Damsel is also translated lamb. Talitha is a piece of cloth, a mantle that a shepherd wore, that when the sheep was hurt, bleeding, scared, cold, or in trouble, he will take the sheep and wrap.
Woo! Woo!
Wait a minute. Wait a minute. Then he said, arise. When you translate that into the original, what he was saying is, he that carries the mantle of glory, power, resurrection, I take my mantle. I wrap you my lamb. And according to the authority and power of my office, oh my God, as a prophet, as a priest, and as a king,
hallelujah,
I revoke the sentence of death. He took his mantle and wrapped the woman, the young woman, and said, kumi, arise. Kumi means arise. That means that the mantle of Jesus was the one that he used to put on that damsel. And as a shepherd, sit down. Sit down. this man to this. He said, Talita. Somebody said, Talita. I cover you. I cover you with my mantle of glory. As my sheep, you're in trouble. But I'm going to rescue you now. As my sheep, you are bleeding. You are dying. You are going down. But my mantle will bring you back. My authority will bring you back.
Hallelujah.
My power will bring you back. The anointing on my head will bring you back.
Hallelujah.
Can I speak to the people of God today? Yes. May that mantle touch you as you touch it.
Hallelujah.
May that mantle wrap you. May that mantle wrap you.
Hallelujah.
May that mantle wrap you. And may that mantle wrap you in such a way that will raise you up from your state, from your situation.
Hallelujah.
Somebody shout and say, God, Talita Kumi.
Talita Kumi.
The mantle of Jesus is the mantle of change. He changed that girl's destiny. She was dead. It's never too late when that mantle is around. Can I speak to the people of my Father here? I said it's never too late. It's never too late. You that are watching me on television, you that are watching me on Facebook, YouTube, on all social media, it's never too late. It's never too late. I said it's never too late. I speak Talita Kumi over your case.
Amen.
I speak Talita Kumi over your health.
Amen.
I speak Talita Kumi over your marriage.
Amen.
I speak Talita Kumi over your destiny. I speak Talita Kumi over your finances. I speak Talita Kumi over your ministry.
Hallelujah.
I speak Talita Kumi.
Hallelujah.
Watch this. It's a mantle of deliverance. The mantle of Jesus is a mantle of deliverance. The mantle of Jesus, when you touch it, you're able to receive miracles. When you touch the mantle of Jesus, you're able to receive change to your story. I speak as a prophet of God. Someone's story will change by the mantle of power today.
Yes.
By the authority of the name of Jesus.
The name of Jesus.
Power of the blood of Jesus. The mantle of the blood will change someone's story.
Yes.
I speak under the unction of my Father. Someone's story will change. I don't know if there's faith in the house. Somebody shout.
Hallelujah.
When you touch the mantle, they said they as many as touched his mantle, they received. Did they? They received. Because the mantle, when you touch the mantle, it has the power to break yokes. Yokes. I said yokes. Yokes of limitation. Yokes of setback. Yokes of disappointments. Yokes of poverty.
Yes.
Yokes of debt.
Yes.
Yokes of sickness.
Yes.
Yokes that don't leave you in peace. Somebody say, don't leave me in peace.
Don't leave me in peace.
That mantle breaks yokes. It's a yoke. We're going to do something prophetically. This mantle has been under the presence of my Father for over 12 months, unused. Unused. The Lord said to me this morning, take and use this as a point of contact. As my people touched my mantle in the Bible, tell them as those that are here, if they would believe, as a point of contact, I'm converting this to the mantle of glory.
Hallelujah.
As if I am there myself. As they touch this mantle today, everybody, he said to me, that touches this mantle that is upon me. And remember the touch, the word touch. It's not just click. Huh? Somebody say that. I like one. How can you touch this mantle? If this is what this mantle can do and more, how can you touch it? What do you need to do to touch it? What do you need to do? Number one, you need faith in Him. Not on me, not in me. Huh? You come for having faith in me, you'll go back. Problem. But when you come to touch this mantle, having faith in Him, confessing Him as Lord and Savior, you see, faith in Him is your connection. The Bible says that they recognize Him, they knew Him. So you see, when you know what Jesus can do, when you know who He is, your faith comes alive.
Hallelujah.
That's why we need to read that word. Because yes. Faith in Jesus cometh by hearing.
Yes.
And hearing by the word of God.
Yes.
It is the word that manifests the Jesus. And He allows your faith to grow. What do we need to do? Somebody say, I need to have faith in Him.
I need to have faith
in Him.
Tell
your neighbor, neighbor. Faith in Him is your connection. Say, neighbor, if you want to collect from Him, you need to connect to Him. What do you need to do? You need to give yourself completely to Him. You need to believe and come bring your problems. Your sickness, your bondages. The Bible says that they just round up problems that were all over towns and villages. They just gathered the problems and brought it to Him. If number three, you need to come to Him. You need to bring your problem, your circumstances to Him. Today Jesus is here. His mantle of power and change is here.
Yes.
All you need to do, in order for you to touch the mantle, you need to believe, and you need to listen. You need to come prayerfully believing that you will receive. Look at what it says in Mark 11 verse 23 and 24. For verily I say unto you, that whosoever shall say unto this mountain, be thou removed and be thou cast into the sea, and shall not doubt in his heart, you see that, but shall believe that those things which he says shall come to pass, he shall have. This is a blank check if I ever saw one.
Woo.
I said this is a blank check. God is saying, I signed the check. You fill in the amount.
Hallelujah.
You fill in what you want. Oh my God.
Hallelujah.
You shall have whatsoever. Somebody say whatsoever.
Whatsoever.
Therefore I say unto you, what things soever you desire when you pray, believe that you have received them, and you shall have them. What do you need to do? How do you touch this mantle? That's another way. You need to come prayerfully believing that the moment you touch, you're going to receive. Don't let demons say, oh, that's just a cloth. Don't let demons say, oh, that's just Ed Citronelli. Forget about Ed Citronelli. I'm not that important. Jesus is the one. Yes. I said, Jesus is the one.
Yes.
I said, Jesus is the one.
Yes.
And then you need to come aggressively determined. That woman with the issue of blood said, hey, I know I'm unclean. I know I'm not supposed to be here. I know I'm violating laws. But I don't care. Put me in jail. But I'm not leaving until I touch him. I'm not leaving until I do something here. Until my case changes. You need to have aggressive determination for your situation to stop. Are you listening to me? Are you listening to me? The Bible says that she said, if I may touch his garment, I shall be whole. It means to attach that woman. Look. My children, when they were little, when they asked me for something, and I said no, they would come and attach themselves to my leg. No, daddy. And then I look, fathers, am I talking? No, move. Just so that they can, because they were clinging. Just so that they can let you go. Say, okay, here, go. You see, that's how you get it. That's how you get it. Amen. You have to determine. And when you come to this cloak, this mantle, with your faith, you have to cling. You know, not so much with your fist. Don't pull me down now. But with your faith, you have to take it. You have to, I say, you have to rip it by the faith in your heart. You have to fasten yourself. And watch this. She said, she touched. He said, if I can touch him. The word touch means if I can identify myself with him. Who he is. He was a rabbi. He was wearing the tassels with a blue thread. She understood the law. She said, this is the one that Malachi spoke about in chapter 4. For I will send my son with healing. The word tassel is also interpreted wings. That's why Ruth, she went to Boaz. Boaz was a representative, like a king's man redeemer. He also had a similar cloth, because I forgot to mention this. Another person that used to wear the seamless mantle was a rich person. Boaz was rich. He had a seamless mantle with tassels on the corners. The tassel also is interpreted wings. That's why when she came to Boaz at the threshing floor, Boaz is just resting. And all of a sudden he wants to move. And he finds this woman at his feet. And she covered herself. Come here. No, come here, Pastor Stephen. No, come here, my wife. Ruth comes. Boaz is sleeping on the threshing floor. With his mantle, because also a rich man was authorized to wear one. She comes, she's snucking. As he's sleeping, come here. She takes the wing of his mantle. Take it with her hand. And she wraps herself at her feet with it. What she was saying was, I want to identify myself with you. As I am wrapped in your mantle, I understand that the Son of God, the true Redeemer, he comes with healings in his wings. I wrap myself with your wings. Hallelujah. And I make you mine. And I am.
Hallelujah.
Stand on your feet, somebody. That's the mantle of Jesus. Lift up your hands to heaven. The Lord said to me, take this, your prayer shawl that you have not used, but it's been in my presence for over a year. And I want you to explain what my mantle is and what he did in the old days, and he has not changed. And he said, take this mantle as a point of contact. And as many as in the service today, this is last night, this morning rather, like at 2 a.m. As many as will cling with the faith of their hearts and they identify themselves by touching, grabbing, clinging to this prayer show, they will be clinging and identifying themselves with my glory, my power, my authority. And breakthrough will begin to flow here today. Healings will begin to take place. Demons will begin to cry out like you have never seen them before. The cripples will be healed. The people that have been tormented will be free. People that have been struggling by the powers of darkness will begin to come up out of it. People that have been experiencing disappointments, delays, setbacks, today, by the power of the mantle of Jesus, that problem will end. Somebody shout and put your hands together for the
Hallelujah.
Master.
Hallelujah.
Thank you.
Follow us on Facebook, Ed Citronelli Ministries, a ministry on the rise worldwide. Like our page and stay connected through live streaming videos and daily posts from Prophet Ed. Ed Citronelli Ministries, where the Holy Spirit is changing lives through Jesus Christ.
I've come to tell you that God is about to take off by the blood of Jesus. That means that no one thought that you will mount to anything. But I come to tell you that God says they should know by now that you are worth. You are something worth seeing. Somebody say, I am something worth.